Okay, yeah, that's your boy GC again, and today it's the day to talk about what you should know before you get married, really. And maybe you know, you already know a lot, but it's always interesting to hear another guy talk about what you should know before you get married. If you really are considering it, maybe your girlfriend is talking about it, maybe she's anticipating towards it. So there are many reasons you might wanna get married. So let's start right away. So reasons, let's start first off, reasons why you shouldn't get married. Because I guess there are more reasons to think of why you shouldn't get married than there's reasons why you should. So let's start off with why the reason why you shouldn't get married. First one immediately is that if you might have the feeling that your relationship might get better, or that you will gain her favor, or things might change in your benefit, I guess you're wrong. Because women, they change, you know, women constantly need this impulse of that you appreciate them, that they're still pretty. There's not a definite answer. So if you would do that, just continue. If you have a little sex and you might think that it will get better because she needs, you know, she wants it, and I mean, that's manipulation. If she really goes like, oh yeah, but you know, we'll get more, I mean, that's pure manipulation. She's trying to get you in a marriage, promising you the tits on your dick every day. I don't care if, I mean, if I've women done it multiple times, and after a couple of weeks, you're like, okay, go fuck off. I just want other tits. They can say a lot. It's like you want something and you don't get it, and that makes it attractive. So don't let them manipulate you into something you don't need, you don't want. If you have a lot of savings, you have money, you worked a lot, and you think you might deserve it, and you think like a marriage, and you have this whole party, just keep your mind focused on it's all a financial trade. So if you might get married, it shouldn't be a reason that because you have a lot of money, it should be like, maybe I can create more money with it, and maybe she has a lot of money and you can get more money. That could be a reason, but just marriage because you have money and she will like you, and you have this money to spend, and you won't bother. I mean, there's more reasons, there's better ways to spend your money. You could buy bitcoins, or you could do a lot of stuff with this money. You could go to prostitutes if you want. So you shouldn't use the money because a woman, never ever, don't let them get into your head. If you are not sure what you want to do with your life, and your girlfriend is giving you some directions, and well, you're together, and in her relationship goals, you are, well, marriage is the next level. You still need to find out first what you really want to do in your life, what you want to be, and how you want to develop yourself with women. And if you have that all sorted out, you can consider a marriage. But do never ever start a marriage if you are not ready, done with your own life, where you want to go, with direction, and who you are, and what works for you, and you got your game with women right, because you need to have an exit. If you get a divorce, you want to get back in the game right away. You don't have to want to leave that up to chance. She can promise you the world, but eventually it's just one woman, and she can die and she can change her mind. So you have to spread your chances. Just be real. Never throw away all your chances in one relationship or one marriage. And another reason why you shouldn't is if you still have little experience with different women, different relationship forms, or and sex, and how far you can push women and how far they can get them in your story. You should be totally aware that how much credit and favor you can get from women, if they're interested in your type, if they are attracted to your personality and all that kind of stuff, that will reward you in not having to pay for a marriage. And if you know all that kind of stuff, you will figure out that they are happy enough just being in your presence, and they don't even talk about marriage. So it's the other way around. So I would say invest in that, do research, and if you are really like, okay, this is my max, I can't get more out of these women, not by investing in myself, starting to go to the gym, dressing more attractive, all that kind of stuff, showing my balls, and you notice like, okay, well, this is the limit, well, then you might start considering, if you got a great woman and you got a great deal, of course, a great trade, because the relationship is just a great trade, putting everything up on the same pile and getting ahead in making more progress, and that would mean for you making more progress also with other women. And if you would say like, well, I don't need that, it's your insurance. I would totally recommend. You cannot, well, like I said a couple of minutes ago, you cannot just count everything in on one woman. You would be stupid. You could, like I already tell you, you could marry for one reason. If it would bring you, if it would make your life personally better, give you more money on paper, and get you more sex with more women, and she's open for it or whatever. I mean, if it would stimulate your manly life, that would be great asset for marriage. If it's not, you should consider. In all cases, if you want to do, there's different views on marriage. You have the male view, you have the female view, same on relationship, you have the female relationship, you have the male relationship. But I would recommend in all cases that if you are below 45, 40, you shouldn't even marry, because you're just too young. There's a lot of time you need to invest in setting up relationships and time. It takes years. Okay, guys, that's it. I'm gonna exit. Hope you enjoyed the show, and I will be seeing you in the next episode. And if you have any questions or something, let me know, and we'll talk very soon. See you guys.